Alright, so we have learned concept 1. In concept 1, we have discussed our charging section and its variations. Alright, its extension, building and land appurtenance there to ownership, and then we have discussed types of property. Alright, now concept 2 is about how to compute income from house property, and I would suggest that this particular chart you need to prepare on new page, because this is the length of this particular table and which will remain constant no matter what type of question you are solving. Alright, majority time this particular table are going to remain constant. Sometime it will become shorter than this, but it cannot become longer than this. Hello. So whatever is there in this whole chapter, we are going to write it in this particular table. Alright, there are three properties: LOP, DLOP and SOPR. LOP means let out property, DLOP means deemed to be let out property, SOP means self occupied property for residence. So one property is missing here, and that is self occupied property for business. That property is not our chapter property, so we have not mentioned the property. Hello. Alright, so business property is not there. Alright, sir, to compute that particular value, annual value, gross annual value, we have to write municipal value first. Now you are going to mention this particular XXX only in LOP column. Alright, municipal value will be compared with fair rent. Alright, municipal value and fair rent will be given in the question. Last time also we have done one example. Say for example, municipal value is 3 lakh and fair rent is 2.5 lakh. We are going to take whichever is higher, and that whichever is higher number is 2.5 lakh. So that number I am writing here, whichever is higher. Whichever is higher number, we will compare with what? Standard rent. We are going to compare with standard rent. Standard rents are given in rent control act, that we have discussed. Yes or no? Standard rents are given in rent control act. Alright. And then we are going to take whichever is lower. Whichever is lower item will be called as expected rent. This item is expected rent. Alright. Sorry, I cannot write like this in first chart itself. It is known as expected rent. Alright, so this is known as standard rent and this is known as expected rent. We compare, what do we take? Come on, tell me. What do we take? First we took whichever is higher. That number we are comparing and we are taking whichever is lower. Now expected rent compare with actual rent. Expected rent compare with actual rent. Actual rent is AR. Actual rent is AR. Alright, actual rent. Now Among these two, what do we take?
Whichever, come on, tell me.
Whichever is higher. That number is known as gross annual value. Alternatively, we call it GAV. GAV is the outcome of expected rent compared with actual rent, whichever is higher. Last lecture only I have discussed logic behind this. Okay. From this, what do we subtract? We subtract municipal taxes paid by owner. Okay, usually it will come in one line itself, but it's okay. Municipal taxes will be subtracted here. Alright, and if you subtract anything from gross value, what do you get? Net value. Alright, and therefore the next number is the net annual value, which is known as, with love we call it NAV. And here our section 23 ends. Hello, here our section 23 ends. Now to maintain house property, please understand, to maintain a house property you need to incur expenses. You cannot earn income without having expenses. Hello, you cannot earn income without having expenses. To have income, you must have incurred some kind of expenses. Alright, government of India doesn't give deduction of actual expenses, because those expenses we took from unorganized industry where we will not get actual bills, GST bills or tax invoice kind of thing. What type of people come to maintain your property? Cleaning and housekeeping. Alright, then repair and maintenance, plumber, electrician, all these people, carpenter. Alright, you understand? So these people are not sophisticated industry as of now in India, and therefore we cannot trust bill produced by assessee. Assessee will always try to claim more expenses. Come on, tell me why. to evade taxes. And therefore, Government of India has clearly said, we will not give you deduction of actual expenses in the chapter. You must get deduction on standard basis. Hello. And therefore, those deductions are given under section 24. Section 24 is divided into two clauses, Chotu A and Chotu B. Section 24 Chotu A and section 24 Chotu B. Section 24 Chotu A gives me deduction as on 30% standard deduction. 30%. So if this value is 1 lakh, this 30% will become 30,000. Now, whether my expenses are more than 30,000 or less than 30,000, I will get deduction of only 30,000. Government say whether you have expenses, you have more expenses, you don't have expenses, you have less expenses, whatever it is, deduction will remain 30%. Deduction will remain 30%. In this chapter, income is also notional, and at the same time, deduction is also notional. In PGBP head, what will we do? We will take actual income, and real expenses. I will give you deduction only if you incur deductions. Hello? I will give you deduction of expenses only if you have paid those expenses. If there are no expenses, there won't be any deduction. But in house property head, whether question has specified anything about expenses or question is completely silent about expenses, you must claim deduction. Because deduction is standard. How many hours we have in a day?
24.
You understand? Hello? How many minutes are there in 1 hour?
60.
How many seconds are there in 1 minute?
60.
You go to VR, it will remain same. If you jump from top of building, where will you go? Down or up?
Down.
First down and then
down.
Up. You understand? Is it standard? Will it happen in VR?
Yeah.
Will it happen in Kerala?
Yeah.
Will it happen in Delhi?
Yeah.
Will it happen in USA?
Yes.
Yes, it will happen everywhere because this is something standard.
Yeah.
Hello. So this deduction is also standard. By default we have to provide. By default. Okay, whether they say, whether they don't say, by default we must provide 30% standard deduction. Deductions are given in chapter. Hello. Deductions are given in section 24, and there are two deductions, Chotu A and Chotu B. Chotu A talks about standard deduction at the rate of 30% of NAV. Iska 30%. Alright, so that number will come. Second is, if you have taken loan to purchase house property, loan to purchase
house.
I told you, government is encouraging everybody to buy house property. Everybody means every assessee. Alright, and why? How they encourage? Government saying that you take house property, you will repay the loan. In loan, you will pay two items. Now, in repayment of loan, in repayment of loan, you will pay installment, yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, that installment have two components. Come on, listen, two components. One will be principal component, one will be interest. Principal component is allowed as a deduction under section 80C, investment in house property. Alright, 80C. So principal component is also allowed as a deduction, but not in this chapter. In chapter 6A, 80C and interest component, interest, jo kharcha hai. Hello, which is expenses for you, that is allowed as a deduction under section 24 clause B. Am I clear? Hello, sure? Yeah, so the second deduction that we get here is interest on borrowed fund. This is the second deduction that we get. And after having this second deduction, the net amount is called as, this amount is called as income from house property. This is income from house property. Assessee has to pay tax on this particular house property. Come on, tell me. Assessee has to pay tax on this property, but this is a positive number. He will be very happy to pay tax or little sad? Hello, come on. We have to draw assessee here. He's a very happy assessee or sad assessee? Little sad assessee. Sad assessee, because he have to pay tax. He's a sad assessee. All right. So we will draw one more chart. Now just follow. Come on, tell me, in DLOP is not a property given by question. It is you are the one who is declaring property as DLOP, because you are having two SOPs. So question will give SOP. You will declare it as
DLOP.
DLOP. Alright. So in DLOP, can we have municipal value of DLOP? Is it possible to have municipal value? Answer is yes. Municipal value will be there for every property. See, Government of India for Mumbai Municipal Corporation, they will give municipal value of whole the satellite park. Now whether the property is SOP, DLOP, LOP, that is the concern of assessing, not of municipal corporation. So can we have municipal value of this property?
Yes.
Alright. Fair rent? Market rent possible? Yeah. So market rent will be there. We will take whichever is
higher.
Then we will compare with standard rent. We will take whichever is lower. Yes or no? And that amount will be expected rent. But can we have actual rent in DLOP column? Obviously no. This is dash. Dash is important. Dash will denote that there is no actual rent. There is no actual rent means this property is SOP. And DLOP there because more than one SOP are there. Hello. Alright. And therefore your gross annual value will be? Hello. Gross annual value will be?
Expected
rent. Alright. So this is expected rent. Then municipal taxes we will have. You can subtract that. You will get NAV. Alright. You will take 30% of it. And you will claim deduction. Alright. You will claim deduction of interest also. Now please understand one thing, and you need to write that thing. If you have space here, please write down here. Okay. You need to write down that word also. I forgot to mention one word here. Here I have to write no limit. What I have to write?
No limit.
And here also I have to write no limit. Just a minute, I will explain you why I have written no limit. Alright. Now, can your SOP have municipal value and fair rent? Is it possible? Tere ghar ki fair value ho sakti hai kya? Hello, you are staying in 103. 102 is let out. Flat number 102 is let out. And that rent, that particular guy is paying 35,000 rent per month. What is the fair value of your house property? Hello, fair value or fair rent? Can it have market rent? Market rent is not for your property, it is for whole area. Does your property have market rent? Are you, how no? I'm not asking, are you paying rent? I'm saying that property, does that property have market rent? Does that property pay municipal tax? Yes, can it have municipal value? It can have any other rent. Can it have standard rent? Yes, it will not have which rent? Why actual rent is not there? Come on, tell me. Because you are the owner is staying in the property, no? But see, in exam they will give you municipal value. But are you dumb to write municipal value here? Hello, will you write municipal value here? They will give you municipal value. I'm telling you again and again. ICI, your examiner will provide you municipal value. But you should not write municipal value. Instead of that, you will write nil. We are practicing writing nil because it is very difficult to ignore data given by examiner in exam. There will be data, but you are ignoring that data. That's the power of ignorance. Hello.
Yes.
Very few people develop that power. Somebody shouting at you have to ignore them. You cannot fight back with every person. Alright. So you have to use your power of ignorance in case of SOP. Alright. What is the whichever is higher? Super. You are talented people, yeah? Now, nil compare with standard rent. Standard rent also, nil. It will be there in question, but I am writing nil. What is whichever is lower? Whichever is higher also, nil? Lower also, nil? Super. Now compare. Now you need to use your brain. Nil compare with dash. We need whichever is higher, dash or nil. Thanks. Nil. Alright. Does your father paying tax for your property? Answer is yes. We have to pay taxes, municipal taxes. But will you get deduction? Answer is no. And therefore there will be municipal tax in question. But you will write here nil. Because NAV, hello. NAV of SOPR, one SOPR has to be nil. You don't have choice. This number cannot be positive. This number cannot be negative. This number has to be nil. That's law. It's not my logic. It's not your logic. Even if it is illogical to you, it has to be nil. Hello?
Yes.
Am I clear?
Yes.
Now, I don't think so you need calci to compute 30% of nil. Is it 0.3 nil?
No.
What is 30% of 0?
Zero.
Good answer. Nil. Ask me one doubt. Come on. Here you need to ask one doubt. If you are writing, come on. I need to help. Come on, finish my sentence. If you are writing nil, then ask me this doubt, no?
Then.
I am not the person who will fill in the blank. You are the person who should fill the blank. If you are writing nil everywhere, come on, ask me. Then why are you? Why are you computing? Why are you writing these things? Why can't you just simply ignore? Isn't it a reasonable doubt, reasonable query that you must ask? Here we have values, so I have created a column. Here we have values, so I have created a column. Here we are having values, but we are writing nil. Then you must ask me why are you creating table? Just ignore. Why can't you just ignore the table? Why are you writing whole table and writing nil? Are you getting any kind of excitement, any kind of enjoyment, any kind of pleasure out of it, sir? Answer is no. Pleasure will come here. Pleasure has to come here. Just to write one number in this column, there can be only one number in this whole column of SOPR, and that number will always be negative number. Government is encouraging assisted like me. Hello, are you earning enough money? I'm saying yes. You have house property? I'm saying no. Government is there, buy your house property. Look at the prices of house property. 80 lakh, 70 lakh, how can I buy? I have savings, 7, 8 lakh, 10 lakh, I can save. But 80 lakh, I can't afford government. Government is saying, still, you need to get the loan. Hello, get the loan, get the house property. Instead of paying rent, pay installment. I am asking government, what is the benefit of paying installment over rent? Government say, I will give you deduction of whole installment, not only of principal, not only of interest, whole installment, but in two different sections. Principal amount, ATC. Interest component, 24. Alright, now this is the property, listen, this is the property which doesn't produce any positive result for government. This is a property which will never pay any income tax. Yes or no?
Yes.
LOP is a property which pays income tax.
Yes.
DLOP is a property which doesn't have income but still pays. Hello?
Yes.
Both of these properties are productive properties of government of India. From their angle, it's like there are three brothers in the family. Hello, three brothers in the family, highly successful, chartered accountant, cost accountant. Your family will always respect this guy. If you are that guy, he will get best services in house. This is a guy, BCom, MCom, something like this. I don't know, has done MBA, has done LLB, something like that. Doesn't work much, doesn't show at least as he's working, but he's bringing money to home. God knows how, maybe white, maybe black, God knows, but your family will still provide some benefit to this guy. Now this is a guy who is completely useless, 100% unproductive. He gets up in the morning, he gets up in the afternoon. Morning we get up, we have to work. He gets up in the afternoon, watch TV for 2-3 hours, get tired, call for lunch. Amma will bring lunch. He will have lunch. Then he will brush. Again he will what do? Watch TV. Then he will be tired, then he will sleep. Again he will get up, mobile, games, friends. Go down, come back, dinner. Again he will be like, night is like so active on social media, PUBG. Alright, now you tell me at night 2 o'clock he is calling, Amma I want coffee. Don't you think he deserves a flying chappal? Yes or no?
Yes.
But if you say, Amma, my exam is going on, and at 2 o'clock if you say, I want coffee, don't you think your parent will feel proud to serve you at 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the night?
Yes.
Why? Because you are one productive. Morning they will give you almonds, cashew. He doesn't even deserve peanuts. Doesn't deserve peanuts. But because they have produced him, and if this is the third child, it is accidental one. It was never intentional. Seriously. They just did something and it happened. It was not planned. Planned was one and two. It is accidental output. And because it is their accident, they are taking burden of it. So he will also get cashew, almonds. But not like this much. If Amma is serving you dish of dry foods, out of that Amma will take 2-3 and give him. Then he will be looking at Amma, itna ich. Utna mil raha hai, nasib samaj, uske wajah se mil raha hai. Wo nahi hota to ye bhi nahi milta. Alright. So he will get benefits. Hello.
Yeah.
But not unlimited. He will get, these two will get benefit. Unlimited. Whatever you demand, you observe this in home. You demand anything you want. Your parents will try their level best to bring you that thing. Because I assume you will not demand BMW. Because I assume you will not demand iPhone 10. Because I assume you are a professional, you will demand things reasonably. First thing, you will stop demanding. If you can't cut down, you cannot stop everything. At least you need food. But if you demand better food, healthy food, they'll provide. If you demand better clothes, they will provide. If you demand 50,000 to pay fees here, they'll provide. They will compromise. They will beg, borrow. They will sell their asset, but they will provide because they have expectation from you. What expectation they have? That one day you should become successful. They don't want your money. They don't want your success to be shared with them. No, no, no. They want you to become successful for you. Primarily. Secondary objective, next objective, third, fourth, there are a lot of objectives. But primary objective, they want you to see. Is it a crime? No. Because they want to see your success, they are providing you benefits. Free home in Mumbai, free. Free home in Mumbai. Free clothes, free vehicle, free petrol, free food. Kitna free khate ho tum log yaar. No sir, I am their child, no. Ha, then, one mistake and 20 years punishment. Itna. Achha, 20 it was okay. 21 still punishing, 22 still punishing, 25 still punishing, 30 still punishing. Isn't it too much?
Yeah.
18, 20 is okay because you are in teens, so you don't understand how life works. If somebody is staying in your house, please understand. You own tomorrow one house and somebody unknown is staying in your house. Using your all assets, breaking those assets, still demanding new. Alright, going and taking things from refrigerator, taking money from your wallet. You understand? How will you feel? And not giving any benefit in return. And not for one day, 2 days. 20 years. Can you survive? But they have survived. Go and touch their feet today. But how did you manage, Appa? How you existed with me? A useless child that you produce. So it's very difficult. So he will say, beta, you are today useless, tomorrow you will become successful. But they don't have any hope from this guy. But still they have to provide basic facilities. Alright. So when we provide benefit to LOP and DLOP, there is no hesitation from government point. Therefore they give unlimited deduction. Here there is no income. No hope of income. still government is giving an encouragement, some benefit. So it will be limited or unlimited?
Limited.
It is, has to be limited. Deduction is there, but that deduction is a limited deduction. Limit we will discuss in section 24. There is a limit of 2,30,000, maximum 2,30,000. There are some condition. If you comply with the condition, then it will become 2 lakh. By default, limit is only 30,000. All right. Now it's time to draw. You tell me. Here there will be a, what is the nil minus negative? What will be the result? This result has to be negative. This is a loss from house property. Negative income means loss from house property. You tell me, this assessee is happy or sad? Come on, tell me. Happy. Come on, tell me. Why is happy? Because there is no income, still he is getting deduction. In fact, that was the only purpose of creating nil value in this table. Otherwise, government could have ignored this property. If I ignore this property, if I don't write this column, there won't be any deduction. We wanted to give him deduction even if there is no income, just to encourage, please buy house property even by taking loan. Hello. Alright, and please do this. So what is the use of this? You can use this loss to set off your salary, set off your income. It will be used as a blessings now. Hello. Alright, now you tell me, this guy, we have to draw only this guy, DLOP guy. He is happy or he is sad? You know, he is first confused. He is confused. Come on, tell me why he is confused. He doesn't have rent. He doesn't have rent, but still he has to pay. He is confused. Come on, clear his confusion. Come on, tell him something. Why is he confused? He is asking a question. Mera rent nahi hai. Come on, tell him something. Hello. Tell him something. Why is he paying? He is asking, kyun tax bharu? Mera rent nahi hai. You are having more than. We assume that there is a tenant who is paying you cash rent, sir. And actually there is a tenant who is paying you cash rent. Alright. So don't feel bad about it. Government is not idiot. You might be, but they are not. Alright. So his tax evasion will be caught. And then he is confused and he will start crying. He's crying. Why is crying? He doesn't earn rent and he has to pay tax. Why is sad? He earns rent, he has income and he has to pay tax. Why is so happy? He don't have to pay tax, but still he is getting benefit, deductions. Therefore he is happy. Alright? Please finish the table.